Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this dissection video, we will be discussing some of the most visible aspects of the peritoneum that you need to know for the abdominal wall, peritoneum, and intestine session. So we're going to start with what portions of the peritoneum are immediately viewable after you reflect the anterior abdominal wall, as you can see here. In fact, in order to be able to reflect the anterior abdominal wall, you have to release the attachment of the falsiform ligament from the anterior abdominal wall. So that falsiform ligament attaches the liver to the anterior abdominal wall. And so when the wall is reflected, it is most easily observable for the parts still attached to the liver. So you can see a little bit of the liver here. You can see it a little bit closer up here. All of this is considered part of the falciform ligament. And it's fairly obvious. It's located between the right and left lobes of the liver. So you'll be, it'll likely be one of the easier things to locate. Now, I think also on the fairly obvious side is a portion of the greater omentum, usually referred to as the omental apron, which is actually a part of the gastrocolic ligament of the greater omentum. And this is the portion of the greater omentum that is four layers. It's going to hang from the greater curvature of the stomach. You can see a little bit of the stomach here, but it's covered quite a bit in terms of some of the adipose tissue. And this is the portion that is going to loop back up and attach to the transverse colon. So as you can see here, you can see in both of these images that it's hard to see much of anything else in terms of the viscera because the omental apron is covering it, and it will need to be reflected or removed to see deeper structures. Also note that the thickness and completeness of the omental apron will vary between individuals. All right, so let's get our bearings with this image. The omental apron has been reflected. The one that we saw in that previous image has been reflected superiorly in order to better view portions of the jejunum and the ileum. Additionally, the jejunum and the ileum have been moved a little superiorly as well in order to best view the root of the mesentery. And when I say the mesentery, I mean the mesentery. Oftentimes you just hear the mesentery of the small intestine referred to as the mesentery. And the root right here is what's actually attaching to the posterior abdominal wall. So any of this right here, a little bit you can see right there, all of this is considered part of the mesentery of the small intestine. And it's actually pretty robust. It's something that I think you'll be able to easily observe. And you can see it on this next image as well. Any of this yellow portion is going to be considered part of the mesentery. Now, note that it has to be attached to the small intestine to be considered the mesentery of the small intestine. You can see some other components of the mesentery. You can see the transverse colon here. All of this right here is going to be the transverse colon. It's kind of been reflected up in order to best view the transverse mesocolon, which is going to be the mesentery of the transverse colon. So in order to see this best, you have to kind of reflect up or reflect a little superiorly the transverse colon. Okay, that is all we are covering in this session. There will certainly be specific portions of peritoneum discussed as we talk about specific visceral structures in upcoming sessions, particularly as we discuss the stomach. Thank you for your time and attention here, and as always, please reach out if you have any questions.